Okay, so we have the sum app. It takes two numbers, adds them together, and display the result on the next page. It's a very simple app. To do that, please make sure in your exam you have the layouts, correct layouts. The top one should be vertical or horizontal, and in the big inside it there should be horizontal. The top one should be vertical, inside should be horizontal. But let me just, you know this already, we have done these exercises, so I'm skipping that for now. So we'll design this interface. It has text view for number one, text view for number two, and a button to calculate, two text fields to take the form input. Double click again so that it becomes a little bigger screen so I can see everything. So what we have done is we have given the text of these text views as num1 and num2, and then the ID of this text box as num1txt and the ID of this text box as num2txt. So we have an interface. Let's give some text to the button. Submit and an ID, submit btn. Okay. So my interface is visible over here also. How many components I have and what are their names? Before I finish this and move forward, I have to create another activity. You're all with me? Did you create the first activity? Did you create the first activity? So if you're given the name and this is ready, create the second activity and it should have only one text view. The second activity should have only one text view. What it will do is, it will display the total number is something. All right, we go to new file, new other Android activity, next. Are you okay?
Yeah.
What happened?
My brother's outside.
So you're not attending the class?
Otherwise, I will wait until 4:30.
So, your brother will come every week like this?
No, only today.
Okay. Yes. New activity. Android activity. Okay. File, new. Wait a second. Yeah. Android activity. Do not create a new project inside this project. We are creating another activity, blank activity, and give it another name. Let's say display activity. So it will display the sum of the two numbers. So I go to file, new, other, Android activity. display activity is the name I gave it, and finish. Once you finish, make sure you save your work, and there should be no error over here. You see, this is my application project. There should be no error. Are you listening? So there should be no error on the project here. There is an error here, disregard it if it is here. There should be no error here. Okay. Now these are the errors we want to clear. You can click on this clear button. It will clear. As long as there is no error here, this is not red color. You don't have it because the error came and it went away. That's why it is shown over there. At this time, like 1 minute before. So you press this button cross to clear the errors. So I have the display activities hello world. Let's just open it and then delete it. And here you put a text view. Keep a text view over here. So this text view will display our result. Yes, text view, not an edit text, a text view. It's a label. Okay, and give it a name, an ID. So let's say result LBL, result label, result LBL. It's a label, yes, it's not a text box, it's a label we created. Result LBL, that's the name we have given it to it, result label from the ID. So this is my second activity. It will, there is no control, no button, no text box, only display. Now the interface is ready. Now I need to do what? Make this working. I will go back to the Java source file. This is my Java source file, main activity and display activity. Both of these are Java source file. So the main activity, here I will read the values, do the calculation and create the intent to pass on to the second activity. To do that, what should I do? Can anybody tell me? What should be my first step? Under the onCreate. What should I do in the onCreate? Sorry? Somebody said something? Maarif? Yes, create the links with the button, link with the text box, also called references. So create the references with buttons and text boxes. And create onClick listener for the button. Right. To do the links, I'm going to create the links for text boxes and the buttons. So text is edit text. Num1 is equal to find view by ID. This is how you create the links. r.id.num1.txt. And semicolon. So control space gives you suggestions. Please, you cannot remember exactly the same syntax. Control space, use it. I'm going to write this line again in front of you quickly, a little quickly. You see, edit. Control space gives you suggestion. It corrects the spelling mistakes also. Edit text. Num1 is equal to define view by id r dot id dot num1txt, semicolon, finish it by semicolon. And you have to have here also edit text. You either write it like this in the brackets, or you have the code do it by itself. Add cast to edit text. Both are the same thing. You write it or you add the cast automatically. Yes, control space will allow you to do this. If you like, you can copy like this also, or type, it's up to you. Edit text, num2 is equal to edit text, find view by id, r dot id dot num2txt. And then do for the button also. Button submit btn is equal to find view by id r dot id dot submit btn, and you're okay. It will complain to you about what's button, move your mouse over it and say it's an Android widget button imported, and it'll say please cast it. Yes, please cast. Now notice whatever you want to read from the edit text, the text field, it will tell you please declare it as final first, otherwise I will not allow you to read it. So you have to have these as declared as final, meaning unchangeable. So you promise that yes, I read it, but I will not change the values. So that's a contract. So the onClick listener we are creating now. Anybody can tell us how do we start? BTN calculate or submit BTN? Yeah, submit BTN dot. Yes, and then yes. How do I write it? Automatically.
Control space.
Yes, and double click this. Now Shama can tell us exactly. And here in the end you write semicolon. Do not put anywhere else. See, it is starting here. So you should write here semicolon. So the block is finished, closed. Now if you see these errors, these are basically import errors. If you move your mouse on onClick listener, it will give you suggestion to import. You take that suggestion and you say yes, please import, and it goes away. Here we will read the values, add together, and then create the intent. So read values, add together, create intent, put data, come on, put data, start activity. So these are the five things we need to do quickly. Small code, but we need to do this quickly. Read values, add them together, meaning the calculation. This is the calculation. And then create intent, put data, start activity. C sharp in Java, int num1 is, this is num1. So please don't duplicate names. Like this is num1, this is also num1. Give a little different names. Do not use duplicate names within the code. Within the code, you have to have different names. Int number 1 is equal to this num1. I want to read this num1. So num1 dot get text dot to string. How do you convert from string to integer? Integer dot parse, exactly. So you put the whole this whole piece in integer dot parse. Integer dot parse int, and all of this should go inside this. Yes. This is the way you write the code. Int dot number one. Do not use the same number within the code. This is num1, this is num1. So within the code, please change the variable. And you read number 2 also. Int number 2, integer dot parse int, num2 dot get text dot to string. Now, the only thing you need to do as regards the calculation is concerned, add together. Int sum is equal to number 1 plus number 2. So, you've got the sum. Alright, so I add two numbers and I need to create intent. You know how to create intent. Intent, my intent is equal to new intent. First activity, which is main activity dot this comma display activity, dot class, and then it will complain you to import. You say yes, please move your mouse over it and say yes, import. And you actually put data before starting the activity. So you create the activity, then put data, and then start activity. So I'm gonna put data like this. You have to do all of this. Yes. How is what we are seeing now? How put extra more time sending? I'm sending sum. So I'll write a string actually. It the first one should be a string always. String is sum because I'm sending a sum. And what is the value I'm sending? This variable, right? So I'll write here sum. This sum is the string name and this sum is the value. You can also send like 55 or 100 or 200, whatever. So I'm sending sum. And then I'll start the activity. Start activity. My intent. The second activity has a label and its name is result label. So let's move to the second activity. This is the second activity called display activity. Okay, let's just keep on cleaning this. Yeah. Right. Now reading. Reading is only two lines of code. Please give it like 2-3 extra minutes only. The two lines of code in display activity.java is create reference and show intent, value and label. So what's the reference? Text view, let's say give it some value. Value is equal to find view by ID r.id dot results label. And obviously you need to add the cost and make it final, because we'll be changing its value. To show the value on the label, you say value dot set text inside brackets get intent dot get extras dot get string, and now you write the same name which you have written. This is your whole code, and this will run. Okay, let's see what did we miss. All right, plus 3 should be this 6, should be working like this. So let me just send this across code to you guys, and then you can follow from there. So what we have here is an activity. It's the same sum application which we developed last time. The only difference is we added a radio group from here. So that's the radio group I've added, and I've given it different text, add, multiply and divide. Now I'm also gonna give them IDs. You see this ID is given over here. I'm gonna give it some ID which I can remember, like radio add or add radio, anything which tells your mind when you're doing programming that it's a radio button. It's not a text box, it's not a text view, it's not a button, it's a radio button. So I do radio add, and then I select for the second one multiply. Notice you should not be selecting the whole radio group. So if you click somewhere outside, you will select the whole radio group. Do not give this ID to the radio group, give it to the individual buttons. The easy way to do that is to select it in the outline like this, radio add, and then this is radio 1. I'm gonna give its ID over here, radio multiply. Radio multiply is the ID, multiply is the text. And then click on radio 2, its text is divide, and that's the ID or the variable name I'm going to give it, radio divide. So that's my interface. Please make sure when you're creating interface, keep saving your work by this button, Control S, or this button, save all. So now really what I want to do is, I want to change my previous program slightly so that I just don't simply add these two numbers. I try to understand what the user wants to do. If the user wants to add, I'll add them, and based on this selection, I will do the calculation. So let's go back to our source code. This was our Java source code. Now, again, I create the references to the widgets on the screen. So these were my edit text of number 1 and number 2 and the buttons. And the second thing I've done is I created on-click listener. Now the program has changed slightly. Instead of adding two numbers, I need to also read the user's click, where the user has clicked, on which radio button. So I need to create references also for all those three radio buttons. Okay, so similar, exactly same way, but I want to create the references for the radio button. So I will have this radio control space will give you options, radio button, and you say add radio is equal to, again find view by ID, r dot id dot, you will see radio add, this is the one I need. And notice, for simplicity reasons, you can have this name radio add and this name as same, you can have this, but what you cannot have is this name similar to any other name on the widget. So there cannot be two radio ads, there should be only one radio ads. And you can, if you like, have this name similar to the variable name, so you can, if you like, do copy and paste. Make sure you keep saving your work, and notice this is giving an error. What's the error? The cast. It is giving you suggestion, add cast, that you're making to reference to a widget. What should I change it in? You say please change it in radio button, because you want to read it as a radio button. This is what we have done before also. Change edit text, you want to refer here as edit text. The variable name also type edit text. This num2 is also edit text, you see, num2 text box is an edit text. So you change here as type edit text, and its variable type also edit text. When it's a button, it should be a button type. When it's a radio button, it should be radio button type. That's all what it means. So I need to do the similar thing for two more radio buttons. That's why I copy and paste it two more times and just change the names. So this one should be radio multiply. Just copy this name from here and paste here. So you want to have similar names, that's sometimes easier to follow. And the third one is radio divide, sorry, radio divide. And we have created the reference for it also. Now, notice how when you want to read it, Android will complain that please make it final. Whenever you want to access any widget, Android will complain, if you want to read it, please promise me that you will not change it. That's the contract. You say, okay, I promise. So you write here, final. Final. And then final. So I'm gonna pause this for a minute. Right, so your radio button, whether or not it is selected, how would you know? By doing is checked. So write the radio button name. It's like this, radio add dot is checked. If it is checked, please do this. This is really what you want to do. So only do this if this one is checked. Now, there is one issue, one thing which you want to make sure. When you send something in the put extra, you want to send based on whatever the user has selected, add or multiply or divide. So there are a couple of ways you can do that. The easiest way is to change this name to result, so that whatever the calculation result is, you send it over there. That's the easiest. Make it result, and the other guy will read the result. So I'm going to do that. I'll send result if whether the user has selected plus or multiply or divide. And here also I'll change it to result, this calculation. Okay, this is basically what I need to do. Int result. And notice the scope of the variables. If you remember what was the scope of the variables, the scope of the variables is only applicable inside a bracket. So intent.putExtra results should also be result. So I'm just changing the name so that whatever it is, sum or multiply, divide, it should always be typed as result and read as result by the display activity. So in principle, this is what I'm doing. So I'm going to put this into if, so that this is the if statement. If radio add dot isject, I'm going to add comments, do addition, else if radio multiply is checked, then you need to do multiplication, else you need to do divide. That's basically what your program should look like. Now I will fill in the statements. I'm going to pause here for a second so that you I'm going to start with declaring result as 0 because I do not know what the result is. So this is the line I initialize it with. And when you say do addition, it means result is equal to number 1 plus number 2. That's basically what you want to say. Result is equal to number 1 plus number 2. To do multiplication, it's simple. Result is equal to number 1 multiplied by number 2. I'm going to just do, so you have to start your emulator first, window, Android Virtual Device Manager, and start your emulator. Once it is started, run as, right click, run as Android application. Now it will upload. Select the emulator where you want to run this. Let it come online. It's online now. Okay. Now it will start installing. Okay. It says installation error, unknown query. Let it start completely. If you want to see the last, are you showing the display activity? The only change I've done there is this. I changed the sum to result. That's the only change. Because I'm sending add, multiply, divide all as a result, so I'm reading it also as a result. Let my emulator start. Okay, it has started. Now I can run my application inside the emulator. Right click, run as Android application, and you can see the console. It is installing as an APK. You know what is APK? Remember this? You may be asked about this in your multiple choice. .apk from your C theory chapters. The application is installed as APK file, .apk. So that's our application. 2 plus 3 should be 5. Okay, let me just... And 2 multiply by 3 should be 6. And 2 divided by 3 should be some floating point number, if you do floating point. We are not doing any floating point now, it's only integers, so it's 0. It is basically 0.66, but we are not doing floating point for the exercises now. We'll come to it later on. So that's basically what's happening. Now I want to make sure this is working for everybody. Any